chuta utataka nitakupama.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's your girl Fanny Lungu back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. I should apologize for not posting the past few days. I had assignments that I had to get out of my way to so that I can properly do this without just doing something by rushing through something without even enjoying it. And I'm trying to find my headsets. I have no idea where I've thrown them, but the show moves on. So like I said, I'm back with another video today. A big shout out to everyone that has subscribed to our channel. Thank you for subscribing, liking, commenting, sharing, everything that you guys are doing. We appreciate you guys very much. Thank you for 17,000 subscribers. I can finally say that, because I was saying we were so close. Now I see 20,000 coming soon. Otherwise, thank you for sticking with us. So today I'm going to be reacting to Khabib's latest interview. We'll blow you away. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
Что бы мог мне посоветовать? Я думаю, что довольствоваться тем, что есть, не смотреть там на тех, у кого очень много. Лучше надо смотреть на тех, у кого обычно ничего нет.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I hope you are well. There have been many rumors about Khabib's comeback ever since he announced his retirement, while many were hinting that Khabib would come back to the octagon for 30-0. The undefeated and undisputed UFC lightweight champion has reiterated the fact that he is unwilling to compete inside the octagon anymore in a recent interview with RT Sport.
Другие промоутеры, например, которые могут прийти после него, да, они всегда будут хотеть, чтобы я дрался, потому что вы же понимаете, это большие деньги, большие просмотры, ажиотаж людей, интерес. Там, где интерес, там есть деньги. Так что я думаю, что эти разговоры всегда будут, они будут меня преследовать.
Khabib Nurmagomedov further stated that as soon as he gets through one fight, fans are salivating for his next one, but said that he has made a stern decision and will continue to be on it.
Ну раньше у меня как было, бой сделал сразу на следующий день, когда у тебя следующий бой, да? Люди всегда хотят продолжения сериала там или продолжения банкета, как говорится. У меня нету планов драться. И
Khabib said that he could fight until he's 40 years old, but he doesn't wish to do so because the goal he set out to accomplish has been reached.
Можно драться и до 40, можно еще как Федор, да, драться и до 45, но цель же должна быть. У меня была цель забраться на вершину, я забрался. Я думаю, что дальше как такого соревновательного интереса у меня там нет, потому что, ну, с кем мне там драться? И если даже есть с кем драться, я думаю, что я так миссия, которая была, которую я хотел там выполнить, я ее выполнил.
Although Khabib has retired from his profession, he's active in not only giving interviews, but he's also outspokenly doing what he does best, advising youngsters. In a recent Q&A, when asked what Khabib thought of about the future of Dagestan, Nurmagomedov was optimistic.
Если сравнить с мировой молодежью, я думаю, в нашей молодежи очень большой потенциал. И вообще, когда люди тяжело живут, вообще, что двигает людьми, это голод, мотивация, все. Когда у тебя есть все, то тебе незачем по утрам просыпаться, там, делать какую-то работу. Или, там, в моем случае, если говорить, тренироваться, да, то есть у тебя есть все, хочу тренироваться. Я думаю, что в нашей молодежи это очень большой потенциал.
When asked about what advice would he give to the youngsters in Dagestan, Khabib replied with such an advice that not only the youngsters of Dagestan, but all youngsters irrespective of caste, creed, place or religion must follow.
Что бы мог им посоветовать? Я думаю, что довольствоваться тем, что есть, не смотреть там на тех, у кого очень много. Лучше надо смотреть на тех, у кого практически ничего нет. Посоветовал бы, наверное, чтобы ценили время, я думаю, вообще молодежь, целыми днями там тратят свои там 5-6-7 часов уходят, например, в том же телефонах. И это очень важный вопрос. Я думаю, что чтобы они уделяли время рационально, ну, как я вижу, да, проблемы. Молодежь, например, то, что я делал, основной совет, да, что я хочу этим сказать, чтобы они правильно уделяли время, правильно расходовали свое время, ставили приоритеты, что вам важнее. Вам важно, чтобы вы сидели в телефоне, там, в отделе, например, да, 4-5 часов, или это время вы можете уделить там учебе, тренировкам, или там посещению родственников и так далее. Много таких моментов бывает, когда вы можете пользоваться временем. Так что мой совет — цените время, то, что у вас есть. И я думаю, что вы можете прийти в себя.
Brothers and sisters, such are the powerful and impactful words of advice coming straight out of the mouth of a man like Khabib Nurmagomedov. Undoubtedly, his words are true. How many of us can say that we spend more time with our families or friends as compared to the time we spend on our mobile phones? We often forget our priorities and indulge ourselves into the foolishness of comparing ourselves with others. That's not right. You are just going to start hurting yourself and feel discontent in your own life. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what you have and work towards what you want. That's the way you can achieve what's your requirement in life. But you surely can't accomplish anything by wasting your time trolling hardworking people's success and being unfocused in life. Don't forget, success comes with your hard work and the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Place your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely and continue doing what you love. And inshallah ta'ala, you will get whatever you desire. Until next time, assalamu alaikum.
Very interesting video with such a positive message. Look at this person that's made it in life, has made a lot of money and is still humble at the end of the day. Some people don't get it. He had a goal set for him and he's achieved all that. When some people reach their goal, they still want to go on and prove that they're the best. This is why they end up even being defeated by newbies in the business. If you set a goal, achieve that goal, leave room for others to come in and also do what they can do in whatever field that you're in. Otherwise, this is very troubled. Young people, sometimes when you're coming from a poor background or a bad, not bad, not poor, what am I trying to say? Let's just say poor background, where you lack things while growing up, you have that edge to come out there and make it in life. And when you make it in life, what are you going to do with whatever you achieve then? And then for others, they're born with a silver spoon in their mouth, so they don't feel like they should put in that much. Otherwise, at the end of the day, just put in work in whatever you want to do and set goals so that you achieve them. It may be short-term goals, long-term goals, all those. You can actually even make them weekly goals or monthly goals, whichever one works for you. Don't set yearly goals, because sometimes when you don't achieve that thing, you look down upon yourself and say, but I didn't achieve anything. You beat yourself because you didn't achieve that thing. Set weekly goals, or actually set daily goals. You know what? Today I want to achieve this. Once you achieve that, make it a habit to achieve whatever you set for your goal, and you're going to reach your highest goal in life. Otherwise, this was very, very interesting. Let me know what you guys think. What are your thoughts about this interview? What you have to say, contributions, what did I miss out when I wasn't posting, everything. Just let me, fill me up on everything. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.